So once we have cleaned our sequences, removed chimeras and everything, we are ready to classify the sequences to taxonomic units. After watching this video, you will be able to describe what kind of tools there are in Chipster for assigning sequences to taxonomies, how the Wang method works, and what the result files, taxonomy assignment, and classification summary look like. So there are two tools in Chipster for this. One of them classifies 16S or 18S sequences to taxonomic units using the Silva reference database. And the other one classifies ITS sequences using the UNITE database. Both of these tools are based on the motor classify 6 command. You are also welcome to use your own taxonomy, and in that case you need to provide the reference FASTA file and the taxonomy outline file as inputs. These tools use the Wang method, which is a Bayesian probabilistic method. So it starts by looking at the Curie sequence, k-mer by k-mer. It calculates the probability that the sequence from a given taxonomy would contain a specific k-mer. It then calculates the probability that the Curie sequence would be in a given taxonomy based on the k-mers it contains and assigns the Curie sequence to the taxonomy with the highest probability. It also calculates bootstrap confidence scores for the assignment. So it chooses randomly 1/8 of the k-mers in the Curie, and by default it does 100 iterations, but you can increase this. If the confidence score is less than 80%, the assignment will revert to a higher level, so it will be dropped. And as input, you give the FASTA file and count table from the chimera removal step. So let's look at the result files. The sequence's taxonomy assignment file essentially contains the sequence name and then the taxonomy assignment. Here in the parentheses you can see the confidence scores, and as you can see there are no numbers, would be less than 80. The classification summary file shows the numbers of sequences that were found at each level. So here we have the taxons at the different levels, and then we have the numbers in total and per sample for these different things, so the number of sequences. If some of you have been using motor before, usually at this step you would run the tool remove lineages. In Chipster we don't do that, even if the data of course may contain assignments to things like mitochondria or chloroplasts. You can remove this after converting the motor files into phylosig object, and Jesse will talk more about this later. Essentially, there are two tools where you can remove selected taxa, or you can filter by taxonomic group so that you only keep the stuff that you are interested in. And here I have just put some pictures showing that indeed there are situations where there are mitochondrial or chloroplast assignments.